So approaching the ring from Supper Punch Boxing Club is Neil Stevens.
And his opponent this evening in my blue corner.
Neil is making his debut in Bradley his first bout, but he's done a charity bout, so his first full proper bout. And he's fighting Bradley Lansdale from Power Gym. I think I saw last saw Bradley here in April where he lost a close fight. Bradley Lansdale coming into the ring. Looks very big, looks very strong and relaxed. Neil, looking nice and relaxed, is the shorter fighter.
Ladies and gentlemen, bout number 13, very kind.
So guys,
by Eastern Demolition.
On our last bout before firstly, the finals of the prize fight bout.
Representing the Suffolk Punch Boxing Club, Neil Stevens. And his opponent this evening in my blue corner, representing the Power Gym, Bradley Lansdale.
Referee calling both fighters to the middle. Read out his instructions. This bout is sponsored by Eastern Demolition. And we're about to get to weigh. So Matt, just exciting, Neil come out, all guns blazing of the Bradley Lansdale. Little bit of a shot to Bradley Lansdale, but he seems to settle now.
I missed it, but I could hear it. I was walking down the corridors and I could hear a lot of body punches. It looks like these two guys are throwing lots and lots of punches.
Big punches there by Bradley Lansdale. Neil moving well. Moves his head well, but then he stops.
Neil's been very unfortunate with his boxing. He obviously fought
so many cancelled fights.
Yeah, he had one where he failed a medical, good blood pressure, which we got sorted very, very quickly. And we're going back June 2022 was actually his fight. So. And he's been in the gym since, so it's a long time to be out of the ring and training hard for it. So Yeah, I'm so pleased we got him in.
We're in round two.
So Danny, I'm going to bring Danny in now. Danny's been MCing all evening. He saw the prize fighter semi-finals at the start of the night. Those boys are about to come back after sort of three and a half hours and give it all again for another three rounds. How do you see the semis and how do you see the final going, Danny?
I'll tell you what, I thought the semi-finals were absolutely brilliant. Actually, Thomas and Eddie were so close. I think that could have gone either way. I really, really do. So Eddie's through in the final. He's facing Jordan. They're both well known on the local Norwich boxing scene. So that's going to be really interesting to see him.
They're actually they've done a lot of sparring together. Jordan's in and out of Elvo's boxing, so they know each other inside out.
Exactly. And obviously with Jordan, he's got Gary Briggs, former world kickboxing champion, in his corner. Eddie's just been on this circuit for such a long time, as you know, Matt. I wouldn't mind a pound for every time I've called him in the ring.
Yeah.
And then the cruiserweights. I mean, again, that really good final. I think this is brilliant. Kasper and Arunis, that's a tough one to call. Really, really is. You've got Suffolk Punch against Elvo's. It's going to be interesting. Suffolk against Norfolk.
We've had plenty of those over the years, and probably I reckon Elvo's have come out on top in general. If we were to tally it up, I would say Dave always seems to find a way of beating the Suffolk Punch boxers, but you've got two start... Arunas and Kasper got similar styles. They both come forward. They both will take a lot of punches. So it'd be interesting to see what is going to go down.
Yeah, exactly. I think fitness is going to play a part in these finals as well. I really believe that, Matt. As you know, it's so difficult to box twice on the same night. And you don't often see it. I love this prize fighter. I really do. I think it's brilliant. And then the winner's going to get £500. So that's going to be nice.
It's fantastic motivation, isn't it? Like, we can all do with an extra £500 in our pocket. So whether it's going to charity, whether it's going to, in Jordan's case, buy him a few beers, you know, there's great reasons for it.
Exactly. These guys, a lot of them have got families as well. So £500 is not to be sniffed at by anyone, like you say, Matt.
So Rob, obviously me and Danny were talking all the way through that second round. You had your eyes on the actual fight going on in front of us with Neil and Bradley. How did that go?
I think Bradley found his rhythm. He stole that second round, back Neil up, and let some very good shots off. Round two to Bradley Lansdale.
Round one, which way would that go to you?
Even Stevens.
Even Neil Stevens or even Stevens?
Even Stevens, not Neil Stevens.
Neil's looking for a way through, but Brad just landing some nice body shots there to push Neil back. Neil can't quite work out in this third round how to get inside. He's trying everything he can to get there.
Lansdale's doing very, very well, going with the body shots, slowing Neil down with the head movement. Neil's moving his head, but he's not doing nothing with it. He's not throwing any punches.
He's Bradley's a rangy boxer, actually. He's a taller man, but also he's got really long arms as well. So it's a difficult one for Neil, but I'm sure he's got sparring partners, Suffolk Punch, that he's been working on as well. Plenty of time to see the video,
yep.
Plenty of time to work it out.
So we've got Bradley Lansdowne pressing Neil back in this round, going to those body shots, really big body shots there. We can hear them in the crowd, Matt.
Yeah, there was, as I say, you know, he's a powerful guy, Bradley. He's lost his gum shield again. Oh, he's given it. I think Taz thinks that he's thrown it out on deliberately, so he's giving him a standing count. I think Neil is getting very, very tired in there.
He came out brilliant in the first round. He kept the pace on. Bradley found his composure, and he come back and he started to work that body very well.
Ooh. Bradley's looking for the stoppage as we go into the last few seconds of the round. Neil just looks like he can't breathe in there at the moment. Bradley's all over him. Yeah, he's giving him another count. He's called it off.
Referee's called it off.
I think he's seen enough. Neil wasn't throwing back for that last yep. 15, 20 seconds there. Unfortunately, Neil just didn't throw back.
He didn't throw back. Right decision, even though I would like to see Neil have an extra 5 seconds.
Yeah, we literally were bang on time there. I think he's taken a shot to the ribs.
I think the rib injury in the second round.
It was a good call by Taz.
Very good call. But very good performance by Bradley.
Boxers to the referee, please. Boxers to the referee, please. Ladies and gents, bout number 13, where the referee stopping the contest with seconds remaining in the final round. Your winner in the blue corner, Bradley Lansdowne!
Bradley Lansdowne with the win, a well-deserved win for Bradley. Not a bad performance by Neil. Much respect for both fighters getting to that ring. Good win by Bradley, well-deserved. So guys, we're now on to our very first final of the Prize Fighter.